Aurangabad, an enticing land of innumerable world-famous wonders, a land bestowed with enriched artistic heritage. Balancing on its extensive time axis are important glorious encounters which run through ancient, medieval and modern history. This is Aurangabad, alluring leprechaun to an ever-hungry traveler. Rarest of the rare carved cave temples, forts, mausoleums, natural sites, exotic sculptures, excavation sites, Aurangabad's colorful platter is full of inviting stuff. Once upon a time, this rocky terrain of dense forests was nothing more than the abode of beastly animals and infinite birds, not a human soul in sight. Only sky-soaring roars of monstrous creatures. For the first time during 2nd century BC, deep resonant notes of Buddham Sharanam Gacchami started floating in the air, and then followed the echoes of rhythmic strokes of chisel and mallet. Basalt, a type of stone considered perfect for sculpting, is found in abundance in mountain ranges of Sahyadri. And hence, out of 1,200 carved caves in India, 900 are situated in Maharashtra. Among these, Ajanta Ellora considered to be the most gigantic, artistically most beautiful. Most ancient, most picturesque region is Pitalkhora. These exclusively Buddhist carved caves were excavated during 2nd century BC. Writings in Brahmi script of Mauryan period are inscribed on the walls. There is one painted cave with images of Buddha and Bodhisattva. On the pillars are engraved pictures of winged animals. This clearly indicates strong influence of Assyrian culture. Ajanta caves are unanimously taken as the zenith of Indian art of architecture, sculpture and painting. These extraordinary caves were excavated at secretive places in Sahyadri's thick mountain ranges among lively waterfalls. This lovely crescent of rows of caves was lost to the world. It was only in 1819, John Smith of British Regiment discovered and brought it into the limelight. Emotive paintings of scenes from Jatak Kathas and geometrical designs on the roof are the chief features of Ajanta Caves. It also stands proof that India knew three-dimensional painting and carving as early as 2nd century. Ellora Caves are the unique symbol of grandeur, majesty and colossal artistic expression. During the period of Chalukyas, Rashtrakutas and Yadavas, Ellora was excavated between 6th century AD to 11th century AD. These caves depict Buddhism, Hinduism and Jainism at one single site. Cave number 16, known as Kailash, the abode of Lord Shiva, is considered to be a miracle in the world of art. It's a monolithic temple carved in one stone, massive in scale. One several thousand cubic stone was dug out on all three sides in a reverse way, the pinnacle first, then foundation. Gods, goddesses, angels, demons, mythical animals, porches, porticos, everything was carved. Overlooking Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar University, Aurangabad caves are situated between Siachal and Satara ranges of hills. Sculptures here are at par with the paintings at Ajanta. Sculpture of Letni of Avalokiteshvar is outstanding. A panel of gorgeous dancers is also stunning. Daulatabad Fort was excavated in 1187 by Bhillamma V of Yadav dynasty. It is the best example of structurally built strategic war defenses. The fort has labyrinth of complicated secret passages, hideouts, wide moat, dark patches and ditches, effective aid for guerrilla war methods. This fort has been scrapped at the base for 150 feet along the complete periphery, creating a cliff of sorts. Total height of the fort is 700 feet. Such was the reputation of this fort as being invincible that even Muhammad Tughlaq wanted to make it his capital, and in 1326, he actually shifted his capital from Delhi to Daulatabad. 210 feet high, Chand Minar, built by Alauddin Shah Bahmani in 1435, is one of the architectural marvels of the fort. The fort is in the pipeline to be recognized as World Heritage Site by UNESCO. This mind-blowing tall fort was built in the 19th century by a Maratha chief called Antur, and naturally is named after him. Ensconed on the spur of the hills of Khandesh, this fort penetrates the sky with dizzying height of 2,700 feet. A facsimile copy of the lionized Taj Mahal, Bibi Ka Maqbara, is better known as Taj of the Deccan and is most conspicuous landmark of Aurangabad. Erected between 1653-58 by son of Aurangzeb, Muhammad Azam Shah, in the memory of his mother, Dilraz Bano Begum, alias Rabia Durrani. Gardens laced with flowers, soft spreads of green lawns, fountains and ponds with silver reflections on their skin make Maqbara a lovely sight. Panchakki is an innovative water distribution system which works on the principles of water pressure. The chief attraction is the grinding mill, which also provides flour to the poor. Panchakki, which works on siphon or tube system, was created by Baba Shah Mahmud. The site developed as a settlement of Sufi saint Baba Shah Musafir, an Asian traveller from Ghazdwan in Central Asia, owing to the work done by his disciples. This striking palace in lime and stone was built by Raja of Bundelkhand, known as Pahar Singh, the commander of Aurangzeb in 1651. Built on impressive fortification, lofty gateways engraved with delicate designs, oblong reservoir with playful fountains add to the royal beauty of the fort. There are paintings in golden color on inner walls, hence the name Soneri Mahal. Since some years, a cultural festival has been organized here. Hordes of foreigners and locals flock to enjoy a variety of artistic programs. One city and 52 gates. No wonder historically Aurangabad had reputation of city of gates. But today only 13 are left. Bhadkal Gate, Delhi Gate, Makai Gate, Paithan Gate are few of the remaining imposing structures. Years ago, in the middle of a serene night, a meteorite struck the earth and created a huge hollow with a crater in the center. The meteorite weighed 1 million tons of stony material. Lonar is the third largest crater in the world, spread around the diameter of massive 2,000 meters. Gautala is a bowl-shaped hilly terrain with sprawling deciduous forests. In 1986, the state government declared it as a protected area, and the region came to be known as Gautala Outramghat Wildlife Sanctuary. Gautam Rishi dwelled and meditated here, hence the village and this forest are named after him. Kedar Kund, a natural spring. Waterfall of Sitakhori, Gautala Pond. Rich flora and fauna are special attractions of Gautala. Bhaskaracharya Nature Education Center at Chalisgaon works on modern principles and advanced techniques. Flora, fauna, wildlife of this area are shown to visitors through digital photographs and models. Statue of Bhaskaracharya, founder of the concept of zero, stands elegantly in the front courtyard. Along the fringes of Nath Sagar Reservoir at Paithan is a sanctuary for rare, beautiful birds. When migratory birds arrive here from Siberia, Northern and Central Asia, Ladakh, Tibet and Himalayas, every branch, every cloud in the sky looks beautiful. Maismal, a popular picnic spot located on the elevated countryside, offers breathtaking view from its height. It's a perfect solace to urban people. A charming lake silently keeps stirring the beauty in beholders' eyes. Follow a left turn from Khuldabad and an enthralling area of Sulibhanjan unfurls with some puddles of mercury shining here and there. These are nothing but lovely reservoirs and ponds. Most captivating is Pariyon Ka Talab. Near the mausoleum of Sufi Saint Jalaluddin Ganjerwa, it's created in the bosom of high enclosed hills as a measure of protection for royal women. It's amazing to find ruins of a dilapidated Shiva Pinda in front of the mausoleum. Hindus and Muslims pray together here in peace and perfect understanding. If a devotee decides to go on a pilgrimage in the periphery of just 200 kilometers in and around Aurangabad, he can peacefully travel for a week. This land abounds with temples, mausoleums, gurdwara, mosques and ashrams. Two most important spots for goddess worship are Bhavani Mata Temple at Tulzapur and Yogeshwari Devi's Temple at Ambe Zogai, Girija Devi's Temple at Maismal, Patna Devi's Temple at Chalisgaon. These also thrive with religious activities during Navratri. Out of 12 temples of Jyotirlingas, 3 are located here. Grushneshwar Temple at Ellora and Parli Bejna Temple were built by visionary ruler Ahilyabai Holkar. These are crammed with people on the occasion of Mahashivratri. Anwa also has a Lord Shiv Temple. It's unbeatable in religious, architectural and sculptural importance. Decorative pillars and beautiful porticos are chief characteristics. This tiny village of spiritual guru Sai Baba has a non-stop draw of devotees from all over the world. A helicopter shuttle between Aurangabad and Shirdi is soon expected. Little ahead on the same road is the temple of Shani Shingnapur, where devotees from Andhra, Gujarat and Karnataka pour in day and night to cleanse the wrath of Shani Maharaj. Down there at the confluence of Godavari and Pravra, Serene Datta Temple at Deogarh is also a constant crowd puller. No statue of God in the temple of Nivasa, just old remains. It is believed that great saint poet Gyaneshwar would recline on the pillar while writing Gyaneshwari. Historically known as Kashi of South, Paithan is situated on the banks of Godavari. Nath temples situated in the village and on the outskirts have religious references. Tradition of saints like Eknath Maharaj and Gyaneshwar still continues. Bohri Society has erected this darga of Rajasthani saint Nuruddin Sahib in Dongaon. Built completely in marble, a charming garden enhances its beauty. On the hills of Satara stands the temple of Khandoba with striking expanse which embraces 3 temples. 250 years ago, one day, appeared a statue of Tirthankar Sri Chintamani Parshvanath, and Kachner gained importance on the world pilgrimage map for Jains and others. Last Guru of Sikhs, Sri Guru Gobind Singh Ji left for his heavenly abode in 1708. Nanded Gurudwara was erected at that place, which is visited by Sikhs from all over the world. Bhadra Maruti Sansthan has developed a massive Maruti temple at Khuldabad. Thousands of local devotees come here walking bare feet. There is another small but serene temple at Khuldabad, Datta Temple. Devotees specially come to seek blessings on Datta Jayanti. There is an astonishing hollow stone here which reverberates with 7 musical notes. It's a wonder in itself. Onda Naganath is a temple built in Himad sect style of sculpting. Khuldabad is a hallowed village where lie pious Sufi saints in deep slumber. The last great Mughal ruler Aurangzeb is buried here in his simple tomb. One of his sons, Azam Shah, and his wife are also buried here. The lofty structures of shrines of Hazrat Jainuddin and Burhanuddin Gharib, who was last Khalifa, lie opposite to each other. The Urs of Khuldabad is annually celebrated where thousands of pilgrims visit to view the Prophet's sacred robe housed in Maqbara of Hazrat Jainuddin Shiraji. Another very significant darga is dedicated to Hazrat Khwaja Muntejabuddin Zarzari Zaribaksh Dulamia, a Chishti saint. The creator of Nehre Ambari of Mughal era, an intelligent engineer, Malik Ambar's tomb is also in the backyard of the darga. In the caves of the same hills is the mausoleum of spiritual guru Meher Baba. Paithani Sari is the exquisite symbol of the cultural heritage of Aurangabad. graceful and rich, Paithani is a romance in pure silk and gold. Its characteristic weaving originated in Paithan, but today also done at Aurangabad, Yewla and other places. Diamonds might be women's best friend, but Paithani is a secret dream lover every woman wishes to have. Yet another discriminating feature of this terrain is Himru fabric. It has reached all nooks and corners in the map as a souvenir. Mohammad Tughlaq shifted his capital from Delhi to Daulatabad, and the whole community of weavers making royal clothes of Himru also followed the king and settled here. Ornate and gorgeously bright, it was earlier used by royalties and riches. Bidri ware originated from Bidar region, once famous as the Mecca for artists. It is done by laying gold and silver on copper. Located in the university campus, this museum could see daylight only because of the inspiration and persistence of late Ramesh Shankar Gupte. It was his dream to put the historical legacy of this region in front of people that resulted in exhausting collection of medieval coins, sculptures, arms and armor, manuscripts, archaeological artifacts. Situated in the same premises of the university, State Archaeological Museum also preserves the scattered precious legacy for benefit of the young generation. Planned in an octagonal shape, built by Aurangabad Municipal Corporation, Shivaji Museum is very appealing. Major artifacts are from the collection of Dr. Purwar. Interesting collection of rare documents, illustrated manuscripts, textiles and coins are there. Aurangabad has a rich tradition of literature and culture. Drama departments of university and other colleges have been fostering very strong theatre activities since years. Traditional dance forms of India like Bharatanatyam, Odissi, Kathak are taught here in the form of Guru-Shishya tradition. Mahagami is one of them. Parvati Datta is the director. To say that Aurangabad is enriched with folk art is a huge understatement. Naman. Gondhar. Bharud and Powada are performed even today. Abhang are sung daily in common households. Many a kings and emperors came here for invasion and came following them different cuisines and kitchen cultures. The city takes pride in many mouth-watering dishes which has a historical past. Naan Khaliya, for example, it is a special Mughal dish. The streets of Chowk, Budhi Lane, Shah Ganj offer marvelous kebabs. Taking guests to Nava Maratha or Lalaji's for special non-veg dishes is almost a religious ritual for an Aurangabadkar. Zunka Bhakri, Thetsa, stuffed brinjals, kachori, samosa, moong bhaji, dahi vada, all these vegetarian items have typical Aurangabadi flavor. Uttam Upahar Grah keeps pouring out heaps and heaps of hot, delicious, delicate imartis. And hordes of hungry lips keep savoring it without break. Same is the story of pedas at Appa Halwai. How he makes it so soft, sweet, yet so crispy is a secret only his family knows. Tara Paan is not only the symbol of reminiscent royal habit of chewing betel leaves, but a juicy center of interesting mouth fresheners. In 80s, this city was known as the fastest developing city in Asia. The very glimpse of city's airport assures us about its development. For any reason, people come to Aurangabad and they fall in love with it.
When I first arrived in this airport, it was very nice and well developed, I think. And I had some business trip today in Aurangabad, all the world. And the people are very kind and very good impressions for this area. And I would like to visit again.
We are in Aurangabad, which is the famous historical city. There's many, many interesting things to see. First time I've been in Aurangabad about 2 years ago.
The city boasts of good roads and has state-of-the-art hotels of international standards. Lemon Tree, Ajanta Ambassador, Rama International, Taj Residency to name a few. Meadows Residency on Daulatabad Road, Wits near railway station, Windsor Castle near Sitco bus stand, and Amarpreet in the heart of the city. Walk in the lobby of any hotel, one is bound to find plenty of foreigners, perfect hospitality, facilities and luxuries of five-star status and personal warmth are distinctive characteristics of Aurangabad's hotel industry. You might have come for business or tourism. There is a wide network of many travel agencies throughout the city, like Vedant Travels, Aurangabad Transport Syndicate, Velvet Travels, PR Holidays and Events, MIP Travels, Pushpak Travels, Vishandeep Travels, Thakkar Tour and Travels, Man Mandir. These names have reached a high watermark. Railway station is undergoing complete restoration. Today, Aurangabad is connected with all the major cities in India, making travel even more convenient. Big brands in the world of shopping malls like Spencer's, Big Bazaar are already there. Recently, another big player, Prozone, has also entered the market. Good auditoriums, seminar halls, PVR multiplexes keep city's spirited pulse throbbing. Bajaj, Umasans, Walkhard, Endurance, Skoda, leading industrial names have plants in Aurangabad. You may be a nature lover, historian, artist, devotee, or just a traveler. You may be anyone. But any time of the year, any moment of the season, this terrain of Aurangabad, beaming with its multitude attributes, will always be ready to welcome you with open arms. You've got to visit this city once in life. Just one visit and a lifelong affair begins for sure. Welcome again to Aurangabad.